Today, we are going to take this piece of garbage into this polished piece of garbage. Why? Well, why not? To make our Space Invaders game, we need some kickass assets. And by assets, I mean an awesome spaceship, invaders, missiles, and of course space. Now, let the hunt begin on
Gulugulu!
Oh, check out this spaceship. Let's download it and give it a personal touch. There we go, our spaceship is looking ready to go. Now let's find the rest of our assets. That was a wild asset adventure. Coding may be easier than finding assets. After a solid hour of searching and editing, we have gathered all our assets. We have got the spaceship, invaders, missiles, space backgrounds, buttons, explosion, and even some cool planets. With our assets acquired, it's time to dive into the world of coding. Alright, let's create a Next.js project. If you're not familiar with Next.js, don't worry, you might not be a web developer. And if you're a web developer and still haven't heard of Next.js,
stop it. Get some help.
Next.js is a powerful web development framework, taking care of all those complicated setups and tangled code faster than a speed of bullet.
Well, only if your Wi-Fi is fast enough.
Now, let's focus on creating a homepage for our game. As a great man said,
first impressions last. You start behind the eight ball, you'll never get in front.
So without wasting too much time, I'll just add a logo and bunch of planets and a start button. And for the final touch, I couldn't resist including an alien spaceship. Hey guys, I'm thrilled to introduce to our incredible sponsor zegocloud. With zegocloud, you can easily build your very own voice chat and live video chat apps in just matter of minutes. Thanks to their developer-friendly APIs. What's even more impressive is that zegocloud covers the needs of various industries. Whether you are looking to facilitate one-on-one calls, group calls, video conferences, live streaming, live audio rooms, or even in-app chat, zegocloud has got you covered. Time is money, right? That's why zegocloud helps you speed up your time to market with their pre-built UI kits and UI components. Say goodbye to starting from scratch and spending countless hours designing your app's interface. With zegocloud, you can build engaging apps in the shortest possible time and focus on creating a seamless user experience. And guess what? zegocloud has an exclusive offer now. By registering at zegocloud, you will get a 10,000 free minutes. To register, just enter your first name, last name, country, email, and verify your email, set a password, and you are good to go. Once you are registered, you will gain access to the zegocloud console. It's your gateway to building your dream application. Just click on create your project, choose the type of application you want to build, and give your project a name. It's that simple. So don't miss out this incredible opportunity. Head over to the zegocloud today and start building your voice chat and live video chat apps in no time. Thank you once again to zegocloud for sponsoring this video. Alright, let's get back to the video now. Alright, let's dive into the game creation process. We already have our space background in place, but let's be honest, it sucks, isn't it?
I don't care.
Emotional, damn it!
To spice things up, I will add an animation that gives the illusion of our spaceship going through the cosmos. How do we achieve this? It's simple. We will make the background move backwards. You didn't have to cut me off. Okay, let's get serious now. How do we actually achieve this effect, since our background is just an image? The solution is adding some planets and animating their movement at regular intervals. This way, we can create an illusion. Let's implement this plan. Fantastic, we have implemented the animation and added the moving planets. However, I still feel like something is missing. After brainstorming for an hour, I decided to take a break to watch some anime. And guess what? I stumbled upon the perfect addition, a speedlines animation. This is precisely what our game needs to take it to the next level.
Wow! Beautiful!
Alright, it's time to launch our spaceship into the space. Wow, it looks cool, doesn't it? But our spaceship needs to move, so let's take care of that. When we click the right arrow, the spaceship will glide towards the right. And when we click the left arrow, it elegantly glides to the left. It's time to unleash some missiles. We will achieve that by pressing spacebar. Hold on a second. We seem to have an issue here. These images keep multiplying and that's definitely not a good sign. Plus, I'm clueless about how to track all these images. Even if I figure that out, how on earth am I supposed to know if they collide with the invaders?
It was at this moment that he knew. He fucked up.
Alright, it's time to unleash my inner researcher and refuel my coffee cup. Brace yourselves, because here's my secret research tip. Listen closely, my friends. Seek out the wisdom of those who have come before you and generously shared their source code.
A few moments later.
Guess what? I have discovered the solution. We are going to use the canvas. Why canvas? Well, there are two reasons. First, with canvas, we can use JavaScript to draw, write, insert images and perform many more actions. Second, I found the source code of someone who has already created using canvas.
Gay!
Let's say farewell to our old code. Just like before, let's reintroduce our spaceship and enable its movement based on arrow key events. Additionally, we will fire missiles when the spacebar is clicked. Now, let's add aliens at regular interval of 5 seconds. To create the illusion that they are approaching from distance place, we will increase the image size as they move forward. It's looking pretty cool so far. But wait, there's a slight issue. Currently, when our missile collides with an invader, nothing happens. Let's take care of that. To check for collision between two images, we will use a specific condition. If the condition is met, we will remove the invader and missile images from the array and update the score accordingly. Our game is almost complete, but how does it end? We will give our player 3 lives. Each time an invader collides with the spaceship, 1 life will be detected. We will reuse the previous collision condition here, but this time, we will replace the missile with the spaceship. Now, you might be wondering why the invaders aren't firing back. Well, in my game, violence isn't encouraged. Okay, to be honest, I simply forgot to implement it and only remembered while recording the video. Let's dive right into the game by clicking here. Now, get ready to blast those aliens. I'm starting to feel guilty for killing those poor aliens. Alright, I actually just needed to test if our life count decreases when we collide with them. Almost there.
2,000 years later.
And there it is. It's working like charm. Now, let's wipe out every single alien. Alright my friends, that's it for today's video. I hope you had a fantastic time watching it. If you enjoyed what you saw, don't forget to subscribe to my channel. Give this video a thumbs up and let the YouTube algorithm work its magic. Before we say our goodbyes, I've got a little surprise to show you. It's the motherfucking Eagle Double G. Snoop Dogg.